Hello. In the previous video, I explained how to prepare the test case for functional testing of API. In this video, I will explain how to execute the test case for API using GUI. To start the execution, click on the Execute Test Case button. From the pop-up, click on Via GUI button. Under GUI, click on API. Under API, you will find three types of testing: functional, automation, and load. Click on the functional button. This will open the right. Wait till the right opens. Click on the test case name by checking the checkbox button. This will open the edit tab. By default, the value of the parameters will be set to iterations as 1, virtual users as 1, and ramp-up period as 1. The values must be set to default as we are performing a functional testing. Now, go to the Run tab and edit the arguments by giving the same name as the test case name, that is AF_LinkedIn_PC_001. Once the arguments are given, click on the Start button to start the execution. Wait till the execution is completed. Now the test case has been executed successfully. Click on the report button to see the report of the test case. Click on the log button to switch to the log of the test case, and again click on the report button to go back to the report. Once the test case has been executed, click close the write. Now go to the folder location where you have saved the test case. Under the Torn folder, you will find the web testing folder. Click and open. Under web testing, click on API. Under API, click on GUI. Under GUI, click and open DemoTorn. Under DemoTorn, you will find a folder name with the same name as the test case name. Click and open. Under this folder, you will find a folder called Newman Reports folder. Click and open. Under this folder, you will find a file called result.html. Click and open. In this HTML, you will find the number of iterations, the number of requests that has been sent to the server, and all the APIs that were recorded in the previous step, the first step. So the number of iteration is 1, the number of requests is 11, and if you scroll down, you will be able to see all the 11 APIs. So this is how you have to execute a test case for API. In the next video, I will explain how to analyze the results for a test case which is executed in this step. To post your projects, visit our website testonme.com. For furthermore assistance, contact us on sales@testonme.com. Do follow us on our Twitter and LinkedIn accounts. Stay tuned. Thank you.